G'day and welcome back to Builtum, and in this video I want to talk about something called the Angle of Repose and the resulting zone of influence that we talk about in regards to excavation. So all material has an angle of repose, and it's different for each different type of material depending on what it is and how the particles of the material are made up. So just think about a load of sand that you get out of a truck. When it arrives on site and it's all shaken out of the truck, it sort of sits up like that naturally. And that basically is the angle of repose, or I think of it more of the angle of rest. So it's the angle that the material will naturally support itself at. Okay, now obviously with sand, you'll see the heaps over time, they flatten out, but that sort of angle is the angle of repose, because the particles are holding themselves there, and they are self-supporting, if you like, at that angle. Obviously, over time, people jumping on them, a bit of rain, a bit of wind, they'll flatten out, but that's, you don't normally get that sort of influence when they're in the ground. So, that's just what happens because of wind and people. So we've got our angle of repose. So if you take that to a excavation type set out, here's our trench, and again, depending on the type of material, we're going to have the angle of repose for our material. So anything on this side or this side of our angle of repose, that's going to be basically self-supporting, so we don't have to worry too much about that falling into our trench. This part here and this part here is called our zone of influence. So this stuff is not self-supporting, and it has the chance, once the trench has been dug, to fall into the trench. Now, it could be influenced by lots of things, water, people walking or machines driving in the zone. And if you go up at the top and have a look, so you can sort of see that anything that was to enter this zone could influence the material and cause it to fall into the trench. Okay, so when we're digging holes, we need to think about what we do around the edge of our trench and how big this zone of influence is. So there we go. Angle of repose, it's different for each material, or angle of rest. And what's not inside the angle of repose is in the zone of influence, and it could be influenced to fall or collapse into our excavation.